Hello everyone, we start here with optoelectronic devices. We start here with module 5, optical transmission system. We have seen earlier optical fiber, module 4, and in which we consider that coupling and a receiver. We can go ahead here, the component that is module 4, we have seen earlier coupling and receiver operation. And this one is the model we need to learn in this lecture. And the next model we have model 6, measurement and advances in optical fiber system. We start here with the optical transmission system model 5. And this model 5 is divided in it a part A and part B. That part A consists of a transmission system and a part B consists of an optical amplifier. Now we start here with the optical system. What is the link? That is a part A. Before start with a link design, so we should go ahead with the basic communication system, that is fiber optic communication system. If you see here in the diagram, we consider here a digital information, a digital link, input data in the form of a digital bits, that is 1-0 format, and it is transmitted to the transmitter circuitry. So we need here the component to match that source, so we can have a transmitter circuit or any other means we require for this particular system. So then the source, it can be LED or laser, your data falls, or based on the current provided by the transmitter circuit. So light source generates a photon, and that emits, that photon of energy is emits through the fiber optical link, that is a cable. Then a detector, light falls on the detector, and the detector provides the information in the form of a current. Then it is converted by the digital circuit available in the receiver circuitry and provides the output data. That is a fiber optic communication. Generally, optical fiber, it has a 3 transmission windows. First transmission window 800 to 900 and operating wavelength of 850 nanometer. Second 1250 to 1350 nanometer, operating wavelength 1310. Then third window 1500 to 1600 nanometer. And operating wavelength is 1550 nanometer. And these are the operating window. Other than that, there will be a large attenuation in the circuit, already we have seen. There are the 5 types of fiber, whether it is a step index fiber or step index single mode fiber or a grid index fiber. There is single mode fiber, multi mode fiber, 2 types. Again, there are the 2 types we can consider in terms of types, is step index and a gradient index. So there are about the types of fiber we are using in a link. Then when signal is propagating through the fiber, pulse broadening occur, and that pulse broadening caused by the dispersion. If you see here the figure, input pulse is transmitted, this is about a transmitting pulse. And here we are receiving that output pulse, and this del T out, that is nothing but the broadening of the pulse. Here a time, and here is the broadening of the pulse, and that is dispersion occur because of the fiber characteristics already we have seen. And because of the dispersion, so there will be intersymbol interference occur, and due to the intersymbol interference we are not able to identify that bit here. Generally we say input normal dispersion, normal pulses. If there is large dispersion distance, okay, pulses can receive. But if you see that these are the input pulses we have, okay, on and off time is same. So in that case, there will be a dispersion, and because of the dispersion, intersymbol interference occur. Your output is that output pulses are overlapped, so that's why it is a intersymbol interference. A fiber link, we consider main thing is of the fiber link, that is optical source and optical detector. We choose a LED or a laser based on the what transmission window we work and what are the operating wavelength. According to that, we can consider that LED or a laser there. And LED and laser, basic difference is about its optical output power and its spectral width. Other parameters to be considered there, but most important is about the spectral width and a numerical aperture that is to be considered. Then a detector at the receiver, we have a detector. When light falls on the detector from the optical fiber, it generates a current and we require a decision circuit to define that what type of informations we have. So for a detector, we need to consider what type of a detector, what is the operating wavelength, what is the responsibility for a given minimum level of power, minimum level of light, how it responds to the output there. That is a responsibility. Dark current, no input, there is some current. Rise time defines how what will be the exactly time required for the signal to generate here, the output. So we consider there the different parameter, detector parameter, responsivity, quantum efficiency, dark current, noise floor, and these are all the parameters related to the detector already we have seen in the earlier lecture. So we can go ahead with the link here. Generally point-to-point link, if you see that when it has started, that is evolution of fiber link, defined in early 1970s, that is first generation, and in which multimode fiber optical wavelength, and it has having the attenuation 5 dB per kilometer there, and then it worked with LED and all, and today's we are using that optical fiber and it has having the low attenuation and used for the long distance communication and low dispersion there. So these are about the fiber link and basic about a point to point link. It is just like a simple transmission link from your source to the user there. Now here a transmission link information source in the form of 0 and 1, and then we require an optical transmitter, that is LED source or laser source there. Then a type of optical fiber, single mode fiber, multimode fiber. And if the length is large, then in between that fiber link we require a splicing. We connect a two fiber there. Then here we are having optical, we have a optical receiver, that is detector, laser detector or a LED, pin detector, pin diode, or a photodiode, photoavalanche diode, that is the detector we are using. And then decision circuitry provides the output of in the form of a 1 inch. Now if you consider the link, total link, and the total link here, a transmitter, that is a source, and that light is connected from the source to the fiber. So here we require a connector, then a splicing, here we require a connector from the fiber to the receiver. Now in the link, we consider that what are the losses occurs in each and every point, and what will be the power transmitted, and what is the minimum power received at the detector. So according to that, we can find out the performance of your system there. Minimum BR level required for your transmission there. So the key system requirement for a link, and that are how much is the desired or a possible transmission distance, is total length of the fiber we require. That's why we need to know about the distance, transmission distance. What are the data rate? Because a dispersions, we can see that, or we can see that what is the intersymbol interference there. Then what will be the bit error rate, minimum bit error rate required for the transmission there. So these are about the key parameters while consider the point to point link or a digital link pair. So generally point to point link, we say that it is the electrical input and electrical output through the fiber using the source and a detector. Any transmission we generally use two types of a transmission link, that is digital link and a analog link. If there is a digital link, so we are providing binary input data to the line coder, then modulator, then optical source. Similarly, we have detector here at the end, amplifier and a decoder and a demodulator of the system. That is about a digital link. And in the case of analog link, we consider that either direct modulation or a subcarrier modulation. We provide the analog baseband signal, then we have a modulator. Then modulated signal is nothing but the electrical form. It is converted and we are getting the optical output there through the source, then detector, amplifier and a demodulator. These are about the link, that is point to point link, analog link. Now the basic requirement for this link design or a fiber optic link, we consider the three components: a fiber, a source and a detector there. So if we have a fiber, optical fiber, then that optical fiber, whether it is working in a single mode or a multi-mode there. For a given particular fiber, what will be the core size and what are its core refractive index profile? Core size and core refractive index profile is most important parameter. It defines what will be the numerical aperture of a given fiber. Because the optical power launch inside the fiber from the source, input is a source and launching the power inside the fiber there. So that's why a core size and a refractive index profile is important there. What is the operating bandwidth or a dispersion of a given particular fiber? What is the total attenuation for the given length? And numerical aperture or a mode field diameter, because if we are working in the multi-mode, then we require a mode field diameter and a numerical aperture there. Then for the given link, what are the source we are using? If we are using LED or a laser diode as an optical source, so we have here, if you see that, for a source, we need to consider the emission length, that is the emission wavelength. What is the operating wavelength of a source? What will be the spectral line width? What is the output power? Effective radiating area? Total emission pattern? And the number of emitting modes. This emission pattern defines the numerical aperture, and the number of emitting modes defines that whether we are using multi-mode or a single mode fiber. Then a detector. In a detector, we consider that pin diode or a avalanche photodiode, in which important parameter is responsivity, and it defines that at what minimum power level the signal is received, that is a detector one. So define the responsivity, and because of that responsivity we can define the sensitivity of our receiver there. What is the operating wavelength of this detector and a speed? We consider that a detector, it will work for all the operating wavelengths, because from a transmission link we know that at what will be the operating wavelength it is to be worked, but detector doesn't know that what will be the transmission wavelength. So that's why a detector is to be chosen. It will work for all the wavelength, so that your link will be used or your system will work effectively. If we know that both the transmission wavelength and receiver wavelength, then we can design the link there. So these are about the system requirement for the optical fiber link. We will go ahead, what are the budget, power budget and what is the system budget for this optical fiber link. Thank you.